Hello and welcome. In today's video, I wanted to share with you a watercolor blending exercise that I found really useful and fun to do. I started off by taking a piece of watercolor paper and drawing 5 squares on it and labeling those squares 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, where 5 indicates the darkest and most saturated pigment and 1 is the most diluted and light pigment. I use sepia for this exercise, but you could use whichever pigment you like. The reason I chose sepia is because it can get really, really dark. So once I had my squares drawn on the paper, I filled in each of these squares accordingly. So in the 5, I tried to get very, very dark saturated wash. So there's a lot of pigment and just a little bit of water. And then I moved on to the 4, where I tried to get it a little bit lighter, just one step lighter, not too much lighter. And you can see that I didn't get the right value. It wasn't dark enough, or it was too dark or too light. And I just played with it and added more pigment. And one thing that helps is, first of all, not having too much water inside of this square, and also going over the square with your brush more than once. By doing that, you're keeping the wash alive so that as the water gets absorbed into the paper, you're actually adding more water from your brush to the wash so that it doesn't dry out as fast. So you have a little bit more working time to add more pigment or subtract pigment by lifting it. And then I moved on to the 3, and similarly, I tried to get those steps more or less right and continued on to the 2 and the 1. I think that the easiest way to do the 1 is actually by starting off with just water on your palette and then adding a touch of pigment rather than starting with pigment and diluting it out. But whatever works is fine. You can see that I'm using the paper towel a lot. I think that the paper towel is so underrated in how important it is for watercolor. When I started watercoloring, I did not use a paper towel for a long time, and I think my watercolor paper was just drenched in water. All right, so that was part 1. Now in part 2, what I did was I drew this rectangle and I chose 2 numbers. So I chose 5 and 3. And I tried to get the part above the 5 to be as dark as the 5 and the part above the 3 to be as dark or as light as the 3. And I wanted to have a soft edge between them. So it's not so much a gradation from the 5 to the 3, it's a soft edge or soft transition between the 5 and the 3. So the way I went about it is I put down the 5 just as I did above, and then for the 3, I put it a little bit away from the 5 and then I seamed them together. And I think that the biggest mistake to do here is to use too much water. Because if you use too much water, either in the 5, in the 3, or when you're seaming them together, the pigment's going to go all over the place and you're going to get back runs. But you should just experiment with this and find what works for you. The next exercise, I did the same thing, but with 2 different numbers. So I chose 0 and 2. And 0 means just the white of the page. So what I did at the 0 is put down some water. And the reason I did that was that so that when I put down the 2, I would have a smooth transition, or I would have a soft edge between the 0 and the 2. I find that it's much easier to go from the light to the dark than to go from the dark to the light. So try this out. Try starting off with the light and transitioning to dark, or going from dark and transitioning to light. You might find that one is easier than the other for you. And again, I'm not using too much water, because if I did, then the 2 would go all the way into the 0 and the line wouldn't be as straight between them. For this next rectangle, I chose 3 numbers, 4, 0, and 1. So I started off with the 4, transitioned out with a soft edge to just the white of the page. And the challenge here is not to get the pigment from the 4 all the way into the white of the page, which is a problem I've had recently. What I did here to help me do that is I dried my brush very well and lifted all of the water out of the 0 part. So the pigment from the 4 didn't have the energy or the water to get washed into the 0. And then I added some more water so that I'll have a soft edge towards the one. And since the one is very, very light, I just added a touch of pigment, not too much water, or else it would again spread everywhere to the one. And sometimes I did add too much water, and that's not a problem. I just blotted my brush on the paper towel and picked up some of the pigment or the water. This isn't so much a gradation from dark to light. It's more like a soft edge between two values. What I did in this final rectangle was I wanted to have a gradation, a soft gradation from 5 to 0, where you can't see the transitions between them. There are many ways to go about it. The way I decided in this particular case to go about it was to wet the whole rectangle and then to go from the light to the dark. I placed the pigment and then I tried to blend out that line by fiddling a little bit with the edge of the pigment, and I tried to keep the wash alive by going over it several times with my brush. So this exercise was so helpful for me. I hope you found it useful. I think that when I sit down and draw an actual painting, like a cat or a mountain, I can ask myself, okay, what do I need to do here? Do I need to have a soft edge of a 3 to a 0? Do I need to have a smooth transition from a 3 down to a 1? And so on. And another thing I think is really good to think about is the difference between just a soft edge and a gradual blend. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and found it useful. If you do find this helpful, do leave a comment, and you're welcome to share this video on social media. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.